Welcome back to the Social Club. We're going to be discussing Manchester United, who are having some real goal scoring issues at the moment, and more importantly, Wayne Rooney, Iron from United People's TV. We'll come to you first, and also then we'll subsequently come to Robbie and Baz as well. But is time up for Wayne Rooney, at least as the focal point of Manchester United's attack?
Yes.
Absolutely.
In one word, yes.
Woo!
We've got some woos going on in the house!
Some woos.
I'm not saying he's finished,
yeah.
But he's definitely not the man to lead the line, he's definitely not the man to lead United forward. I think he'd be better off as an impact striker,
yeah.
On the bench, coming on for that last half hour. You know, that's give him a chance to run it.
That's a bloody expensive impact striker off the bench.
It is, but that's the club's fault. We should never have given him that 5-year deal or whatever it was, at what he's being paid.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Martial, he's out on the left. He's doing a lot, you know, like with his runs and passing, but I still think he'd be miles better, as the man up top.
Well, that's the obvious one. I mean, Barry, before we move on to Martial, because I think it's an important point to make, I mean, you're pseudo-president of the Wayne Rooney fan club. Ever since he came back and had a little go in the blue shirt again, and you sort of went, oh,
nostalgia kicked in. We forgive you, Wayne. All is forgiven. You can have him back, honestly.
Is there a question in there somewhere? Barry would like to say not the president.
For clarification, yeah. Those are not the views expressed by Paul Mason are not those of Barry Cannon.
Well, where do you stand on him? Because I think I agree with that. From what I've seen, I watched a lot of Man United at the start of the season, and I've watched a bit recently. I don't think he's ever been a pure lead the line centre forward. If I'm perfectly honest, do you agree? Do you disagree? What do you think's wrong? Can it get better?
Of course, it can get better. He's a top player, but he was good. You know, United came down to a Goodison team that can't score and scored three. Which imagine. Tim Howard was in goal, so big anyone was good. But Andy Rooney was excellent that day. Held it up, brought other players in, enabled Martial to do well off the flank. You know, but for me, it's one of those players. Every club looks to someone to try and bat you off the side. And United at all, you know, great United sides under Fergie, everyone scored goals. Everyone. This side isn't a great United side. And the manager, I've said it before, put a good manager in charge of United with some of their players they've got, and I think they'd be flying. I really, they've got some real, real class in that side. But Van Gaal, I'm just not convinced by it. I've said this to, you know, many a time, it just doesn't convince me in the slightest. He's a big character and all that, but it's not United that we were used to. As for Rooney himself, players come to the end of the cycle at a club, you know, and he's 30 now, he was 30 a couple of weeks ago. You know, and he probably isn't the player that he was, of course.
That's a lot of time. We discussed this a lot, about how you only really get, I think, 10 years at the peak of your powers. Kid's been playing Premier League football since he was 16. Yeah. He was a kid then.
Yeah, he's 2 years younger than me now.
He's an old 30, isn't he?
Yeah. Yeah.
He's an old 30 in football terms.
He's already on a second set of hair.
Yeah. I honestly believe that he can still do it. I just think it's on a club like Man United where it's such media, such focus. You know, I think if he was out of this,
I think he's a number 10. I think he's a number 9.
What's the problem with dropping him?
That's the thing.
The guy's not on form. He's not playing well.
Doesn't want to do it. I don't know why.
You know, he's
stubborn. He's, you know, the stats, you know, speak for themselves. You know, he's not scored for ages. You know, like, you know,
that doesn't sound like a stat. Per se, but it feels like you're in the ballpark.
It is that with that.
Go on.
He didn't have a touch in the box on Saturday against Palace.
Yeah, that's
there was one where I don't know whether it was Martial threaded him through.
Wayne Rooney would have scored that.
But that's what I'm saying, yeah. Right? Why don't they just, you know, what I can't get my head around is the guy is badly off of form. It's almost like they're scared to drop this guy.
Do you have the options to drop him?
Drop him. Let him, you know, have a little time when he's on the bench. Let him rediscover his game again, then come back. But at the moment, the guy's, he's playing, he's rubbish at the moment.
Yeah, he's having enough. Because obviously, Depay's not been amazing since he joined. I think he's got better than your other partner than
yeah, yeah.
But so he's clearly the option, and you've got Martial there. You can play through the middle. Is that enough? Is that a better alternative to what's being done?
Yeah, potentially, yeah. Because I said, like, I reckon Martial would be better just up top by himself, yeah, and having, you know, someone just behind him just pinging the balls into him. Whereas Rooney, he just kind of drifts in between the, you know, the midfield and, you know, rarely to the front, and that's.
I look on this, right, is that, as I said, if you drop Rooney, they've been trying to accommodate Rooney for so long. It's the same even with England.
I don't think he'd be there. If Ferguson stayed that club, I don't think
he'd be there. If Fergie was still there, he wouldn't be playing in the team right now, right?
I agree. He'd have been sold.
Now, even trying to push him further back to play, to me, I think Herrera should be playing there. Or Mata should be playing there, you know, just behind. That's where I think United would be very dangerous if one of those two were playing behind Martial. So, Rooney, until you find back your form, you should be on the bench. I mean, I'm glad they're leaving him in at the moment, right? But saying, I don't get it. I don't understand it. Every United fan I talk to says that, you know what, he's just not playing well for so long. Even though he's a captain and that, I mean, the captain of our club is you know, he's on the bench.
Mikel Arteta,
he's on the bench. He can't get in the team right now, but, you know, Vermaelen before that was a captain.
Mikel Arteta fan club.
But even before that,
Vermaelen
was our captain. He was, you know, just because you're the captain shouldn't mean that you're automatically
going to
be in the
team. I know James Miller's only our vice, but we brought him off in the second half of that game. I don't think Rodgers would have done that, but, you know, sometimes your manager's just got to go.
I still think Rooney's got. He's got something to offer. He's not going to be the Rooney of years gone by. He's still got things to offer. But if somebody's so badly off form,
I think
give him a break.
I don't think any player should be undroppable. I don't. We've got a situation at our club with the goalkeeper where he's undroppable, and he shouldn't be because he's been garbage. But no one should be above getting dropped. Rooney, take him out, let him get refreshed. Might come off the bench half an hour, a couple of games, score a couple of goals. Confidence starts coming back. Centre forwards need goals. He's got no confidence. He'll be aware that United fans, some of them are having a pop at him. Others will be willing him to get back to the way he was. You know, when it's down to your manager, good managers protect not only the side but the players. And when players are having a rough time, you've got to take them out.
Well, we got lucky to some extent. We rested Coutinho for the League Cup in the week. Everyone was saying dropping for Chelsea as a game off. Brings him back in, scores two goals, and obviously different circumstances. But I just, I come back and I look at that chance we mentioned there, where Martial feeds Rooney through.
Yeah,
he's too slow, you know. And I know obviously you wouldn't want to reverse it because then you've got Rooney playing left wing, which is a whole other set of problems. But Martial's the guy who gets onto that all day long. He's round the keeper and he slots it.
To me, it all points back to that time with Rooney, right? Where he was in his house and he got knocked out. Right? Ever since that, he's not
there. He is the same.
He ain't been the same since his legs are gone. No, I couldn't resist that.
I honestly, it's the formation thing. That's ruined it. That's the problem.
I just don't think you can build a team around Wayne Rooney. And this is why England we're not going to get into it now, but I can't stand England because they always build the team around the wrong player.
However, you know what? Is there an argument to say, I know we are all digging out Rooney at the moment, but is there an argument to say that the style of which how Man United are playing at the moment, it's not conducive to scoring goals either, because where's the wing played? They seem to play with all these holding midfielders. They're not scoring goals in general, are they?
That final third.
Yeah, it is. So, you know, it's the service being provided to Rooney as well. I mean, I don't watch as much of United obviously as you do. But is he? And it's the last game of Match of the Day as well. So I don't really get to see much. Is he getting the service?
Rooney drifted in between like the midfield and like, you know, up top, and more time is, you know, towards the midfield end of the field. And
but players like Depay getting crosses into the box where Rooney can latch onto it. Are those sort of, you know, I'm not seeing those sort of chances from the wing player.
I look at it and say, you know, when United were last at the best, they had two, I think Ferguson even described it, 2 9.5s in Van Persie and Rooney, and they worked on the interchange. Neither of them was an out and out on the shoulder of the last man. But the minute, actually, they don't seem to have that balance, at least from the outside.
Was Rooney even been the decline from then? Because remember, Van Persie was starting all the time.
Yeah.
So was, you know, has the decline sort of been from there? I'd say
at least 2 years Rooney's been on the decline. Some would say even longer.
To Wayne Rooney, we were here a few weeks ago talking about him for England. He's England's all-time whatever. But he's still a good player. He's still got quality. You don't become a rubbish player overnight, do you? There's clearly something there. It's about getting the best out of it to some extent. Let me thoughts. Is time up for Wayne Rooney? Is he finished? Is he not? Let us know your conflicting and doubtless angry opinions in the comment section below. Give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the Paul City YouTube channel for more. We're also going to be discussing Joe Campbell at Arsenal, the one everyone wants to really be talking about. Gold crazy Everton and their sensational centre forwards. We're going to be picking the best Premier League managers and a whole lot more. So check out the rest of the show.